My name is Stephanie Mero. I'm about to be 29 years old. I live in Orlando, Florida, and this is my Diva Curl story. So I was a Diva Curl specialist, stylist for 4 years. It was the first product for curly hair that I used after finishing hair school almost exactly 5 years ago now. And I was still flat ironing my hair every day when I finished hair school. I went to a salon that carried Diva Curl to work, and they had me try the products, and I saw some hope that my curls could come back. Went through a pretty tough transition with my hair. Eventually realized it just wanted to get a totally fresh start. And so last April 2018, I decided to just cut all the damage off and start over at about exactly the length I am right now. So I stuck with the Diva Curl products. I specialized in curly hair, eventually only doing curly hair, and I used them on my clients. I used them on myself. And back in this year, February, when I decided to start a YouTube channel, I was still using only those products. I never had got any free product from Diva Curl. The only thing I had ever received from Diva Curl for free or any kind of partnership that occurred was actually when they wanted me to work for the company and they gave me their training in Soho to become a diva stylist for free. So that was great. I was already doing curly hair before that, but then I was able to get on the stylist finder. And I actually earlier this year, before the whole debacle with the actual products happened, and I was still using the products, but I got taken off the stylist finder because I realized I really wasn't doing a diva cut anymore. I developed my own style, and so I didn't want people to come to me expecting to get some diva cut they had seen on YouTube or something like that. They needed to know that the way I do things was my own way. So I had them take me off. That being said, I kept using the products because I liked them a lot. I will say that earlier this year, I definitely noticed some of my clients who I'd had for a long time developing dry hair and their hair getting thinner and their curls looking less curly, but I would never have thought it was the products because we had been on those products forever. We hadn't changed anything, so it couldn't be the products. I remember with one client, I ended up asking her a bunch of questions. Like, I was trying to figure out what happened to her hair. I decided, okay, maybe she's just pulling it up too much. I was like, don't pull it up so much because it was looking thin, especially here, and her curls were like almost gone. Her density was so much less. Her hair felt very rough to the touch. And I probably saw it on a few other clients before realizing what it was. Really for me to fully understand that it was the Diva Curl products causing the hair loss and damage, it had to happen to me. I'm glad it happened to me because I probably wouldn't have realized what was going on. I would have just been like, oh, it's probably just too moisturizing for them now. Because like that's what people on the internet were saying, was like, oh, it's too much moisture, or it's too much protein, or it's not enough. And you know, I got brainwashed by the echoes of people online telling me what was wrong with my hair, why it was starting to get dry. I made a video showing like my hair around this time earlier this year. Like, I'm a professional and I don't even know what this is. Like, why is my hair like this over here? Like in this area above my ears, it was all sticking together when it was dry. It was super, super tangly, even if I had just detangled it. I was like, what's going on? And everyone was like, it's over moisturization. So I was like, okay, well, I guess I'll stop using the shampoo and conditioner from Diva Curl and I'll switch to something else. But I kept using the styling products because I liked the styling products, and you guys know how hard it is to find styling products that you like. So I was using pretty much all their stylers, switching them out, layering them sometimes, except for the gels. I never really liked the gels very much, so I stayed away from those. But that being said, I've now seen damage from clients who only use the gel, who just didn't want to give up the gel, and their hair is totally destroyed. So my hair was getting dry. I had moved to Miami in January, and so I was like, well, my hair was growing out. It was so big, so beautiful. My hair is very, very dense. It was looking amazing, and then it started getting dry about at the same time that I started going to fitness classes in a studio that's over 100 degrees. started to get dry. I was like, okay, it's like summertime. It's probably the humidity. I've never grown my hair long and natural before, so maybe this is just how my hair is. Still, I would not, my mind would not go to maybe it's the Diva Curl products that were in my hair when I went to the classes. So after about 3 months of going to the classes, a bunch of weird things had happened to my hair. My layers were getting shorter without me cutting them. I didn't really notice this so much until now when I look back on photos, because you see yourself every day, and my YouTube subscribers, I was making videos like every day, so none of us were like, whoa, what happened to your hair? Because it was kind of happening slowly. But I had some blonde highlights, and when I started trying to figure out what was going on with my hair, it was starting to look so dry. I was like, it was looking very warm, so I went to tone it. Now, I'm a colorist, I know how hair color works. And this has never happened to any clients of mine before, not at least by my doing. I went to tone my hair just to cancel some warmth, and it turned dark purple. What I said after that was, I was so busy in the salon, I don't have time to think about me and what's going on with my hair. I gotta worry about my clients. So I just ruled it out as my hair just hates being blonde, and I leaned into the red purple color. I put a red purple demi on top of it just to even it out, because it didn't grab it evenly. And I just moved on. People were like, I love the purple, it looks so good on you. So I didn't ask any more questions to myself about what happened. I was just like, well, it looks good, so who cares? Which, looking back, understanding that hair doesn't do that unless it's extremely, extremely porous and damaged. No amount of moisture or protein would cause hair to do that. So then I'm flash forward just a couple of weeks in September, from when the color thing happened. In September, I'm visiting my parents, and like I mentioned, I wasn't using the shampoo and conditioner from Diva anymore, just the styling products. So I wash my hair, and then I realized the only conditioner I had at my parents' house was like a pretty new big tub of Melt Into Moisture. I used a little bit because I just was like, I'm not going to skip conditioner, you know? And my hair was freaking out before it even dried. It was all separating, looking crazy. It was already not looking good, but I had never seen it while still wet, frizzing up like this. I also got a little bit of the conditioner in my eye, and my eye was blood red. I had to rinse it underwater like you would do in a chemistry classroom. It was crazy painful. I have got cleaning products in my eye before that didn't hurt me that badly. So my hair's looking crazy, and I don't have time to rewash it. I go out to the store. As it dries, it's getting worse and worse and worse. So I come back home. I wash my hair again without the conditioner, and it looked better than with the conditioner. And that's when the light bulb went off. It's something in the Diva products. Like, oh my God. I need to stop using these. I need to tell my clients not to use them. I don't know what's going on yet, but I know that something's wrong, and I just don't want anyone else to suffer. So the next day I went to work in the salon, and I had the same client that I had seen months before, who I had thought that pulling her hair up too much was the problem. And her hair was even worse. I hadn't told her to stop using Diva Curl because I thought Diva Curl was the best. It was the best for so many years. Why would it not be the best now? And her hair was like mine. I realized the similarities, and it was like, okay, you gotta stop using Diva Curl. We made a video right away at that moment showing her hair, and we were like, I don't know what's going on, but something's changed in these products. You should stop using them. And I mean, people freaked out. Everyone on the internet freaked out. I had to send a mass email to all of my clients, which was over 700 people, because I only do people's hair like once or twice a year because the haircut lasts a long time. So I had tons of clients in the last 4 years that I had told to use Diva Curl. So I had them all in my system. I emailed all of them. It was horrifying to have to do, to say, hey, something I told you to use could be messing up your hair. And I know that any influencer that's going to share this video is going to feel the same way, but know that you didn't know. And so there's nothing you could have done differently except predict the future or expect something to happen that shouldn't happen. Consumer products should not damage your hair and scalp. It should not be possible. It shouldn't be able to happen, even if they're exposed to heat. So I had the realization something's wrong with the products. The way that I figured out what was wrong with it was by realizing that it was something common among all the products, because I was having people, my salon became the Diva Curl recovery room. I don't remember the last time I did hair that was completely healthy. It's incredible how many people use at least one Diva Curl product. Like, it's gotta be a really high percentage of the curly universe that uses these products. Now I was like, well, so how come some people's is more severe than others? How come some people are reporting like burns and immediate allergic reaction, while others like me, it had to be like exposed to a lot of heat for it to affect me so much? Maybe it was affecting me a little bit for my hair to totally freak out and for me to have so much hair loss that I saw literally a whole curl come out in the shower. It was that heat exposure was the factor that took the same products that were kind of bad to being super, super bad. So I briefly, before doing hair, had a job that was connected to the logistics industry. Logistics is like distribution and all of that, warehouses, storage. And I was like, wait, what if it's the way they're being stored? What if that changed? What if they're not climate controlling the warehouses anymore and the products are getting hot before they even get into our hands? They change the way they're storing them, because I talked to Diva Curl and they were like, we didn't change the formula. Why would we change it? It's amazing. We put the curly girl first. They just kept saying that over and over again. I was like, that's not an answer to what's going on. So whether Diva Curl stores the products themselves or outsources to a third party distributor, something introduced heat to these products. Cosmetics are supposed to be climate controlled if they don't have a lot of cheap preservatives that keep them from going bad or changing. So something happened with heat. That's why mine got so much worse when I started going to the hot classes. And that's why the reactions are varied because a chemical reaction isn't going to be uniform between every product. It's going to release different amounts into each bottle. So is it a chemical that's in the product, an ingredient that causes a harmful ingredient to be released when heat is introduced, and that ingredient is in all the products? So maybe a preservative or something, or did they change the plastic that they're using too? Or maybe they always used cheap plastic and the heat caused that plastic, the packaging, to release something into the products. These are the theories that I have. They're not just randomly made up theories. It's been months of me being slammed with questions, having to explain myself, having to defend every single question that's asked. And this makes sense. It makes sense. I haven't been offered a better theory yet. It's not buildup. Product buildup, do you know how disgusting your hair and scalp would be before you'd have so much buildup that you would have hair loss? Also, the hair loss looks like it's hormonally caused. It's caught for women, it's been concentrated in the recessions of the hairline. These are the weak areas of the hair that also, often that's where women lose hair after they have a child, called postpartum hair loss. For men, it's manifesting more in the male pattern baldness areas up in the top here and throughout the top of the hair. So, because my husband also does hair, he does a lot of men's hair, he does a lot of curly men's hair, and they're having the same problems. The hair damage is the same whether it's men or women. Hair is hair, but our hormones are different. So what that indicates is that absorbing this chemical into your body is deflecting your hormones in some way that's causing this type of hormonal hair loss. So that's scary, but our skin is our largest organ, and it does absorb, and now that goes into your body and it does affect you. And that's why cosmetics are monitored by the FDA in the United States, but they're really overlooked compared to a lot of other things that they deem more important to focus on. So, why are some people's more than others? Why do some people, is because of it's a chemical reaction, it's not going to be the same among each. Some people have shared that they can smell the chemical in the product even. It has affected the viscosity, which is the liquidiness. If you've got a product and maybe you're like, why is it so much more liquidy than it used to be? Or the color is a little bit different. A lot of people have reported Low Poo Delight being darker in color and thinner. So there's a lot of parts that connect to this situation, that all signs point to that there's a highly alkaline chemical. Alkalinity would blast open the cuticle of the hair, which is the outer layer of the hair, causing it to tangle profusely. Highly alkaline substances are horrible for us, horrible for our scalp, and would cause hair loss over time, and also can be cancer causing as well. So this is a really, really big deal. It's time for the FDA to take it more seriously. It's time for us to continue to raise awareness until then. And One last thing to touch on, because I've been asked all kinds of questions, and this is a common one, is how come my products haven't negatively affected me yet? And that's because it takes time for the distribution cycle to go on to a place where every single person would have the tainted products in their home. So where you live, where you buy from, there's definitely still safe products on the shelves. It's just a matter of how quickly does the place you buy your product from go through their own supply and then replenish. So I'm sure Diva Curl is aware of this situation. I'm sure they're doing everything they can to fix it, but the thing they're not doing is issuing a recall. So until they do that, I'm gonna keep speaking out. I hope that you guys will too. If you have questions for me that weren't answered in this video, you can send me an email, thecurlninja@gmail.com, and I'll do my best to answer them for you. There's also a Facebook group called Diva Curl Hair and Scalp Issues. You're not alone. I administer that group. I made it in September when I realized what was going on, and it's got over 3,000 members now. That's where you can get support. That's where you can find other answers to your other questions. And for anyone out there that's suffering, I'm so sorry. I will say that the damage seems like it can't be repaired fully. It needs to be cut off at some point. I do have videos on YouTube about how to manage that damage, because that's what I've been working with in the salon. So even though I chose to cut off all my hair and start over back in October, most people aren't ready to do that. And so I'm doing my best to help you learn how to style it and manage it until you can cut it off. That being said, once you stop using all of the products, your body should re-regulate and start to grow hair back. I was totally bald spots here and here, and it, as you can see, it is filled in and throughout as well. So like I said, if you need me, I'm here for you. I'm doing my best to speak out. As much as it's been a burden, it feels like the most important thing I've ever done. I hope you guys will help me spread the word. I hope that you will be brave, because it is, you know, scary, but I want you to know that I've been speaking about this very intensely since September. Diva Curl has not come after me. They would have to prove that what I'm saying is not true. That would mean they would have to get the products tested, which they have not. They have only tested the samples that they keep of the products, not the samples that have been sitting in the warehouses. So what they need to do is test the products, or we need to get the products tested that were returned to Diva Curl from the people who said that they were having negative reactions. That being said, I could literally go to a store and find a product, and I'd be able to play with it and know if it's a bad product or a good product. Like I said, it affected the viscosity, so the thinness of the product, and I could bring that to a lab, but it's very expensive, and the amount of time I've had to take off work to address this issue and to also focus on, this was a huge distraction from a book that I just put out, but it has been not a good financial place for me, so I can't do it on my own. If you guys want to organize a GoFundMe or something like that, I'm happy to contribute to it. I'm doing everything I can right now, but I do plan to do more. So let me know how I can help you. I love you guys. If you haven't been affected yet, please heed this warning. You know, yes, the products cost you money. You can try to return them to Diva Curl by contacting them, but just know that the suffering is, you can't put a price on it. You really can't. And I can't tell you, hey, go use this. This will fix it. What I can tell you is the most important thing is that you stop using all of the products before they affect you negatively. And, or if you know that what you have isn't affecting you negatively, seriously reconsider restocking, because it could be the next purchase that ends up hurting you. I have nothing against Diva Curl as a company. This might have happened completely out of their hands, and now they're panicking and doing everything they can, and it would cost them millions and millions of dollars to issue a recall. So, especially because they just moved into Europe too. So I just have to raise awareness, because I care about, this message is more important than me. And so I hope that you're really hearing it, and I hope that you believe it, and that you can be brave and help share it, because you never know who you're gonna reach and how that's gonna impact somebody else in a positive way. So I love you guys. If you wanna contact me, like I said, thecurlninja@gmail.com. My Instagram is thecurlninja, but please don't DM me. Send me an email if you have a serious question, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. So thank you to anyone sharing this video. Thank you for spreading the word and doing your part. Love you all. Bye.